Colinga State Hospital, prison unit. Have you ever been committed to a hospital for psychiatric reasons? It feels weird for me to say I have. I do not see myself as suffering from a mental illness, unless we consider being sentenced to life in prison as an illness. So maybe I am ill, ill enough to cut my wrist because of a lifetime of punishment by a state I love, country I love. An illogical, horrible crime committed by an illogical 16-year-old kid led to my illogical 15-year-old self getting an ill, thought-out punishment of 25 years to life in the adult prison system. So ill, but so real. So was my stay for a year in Colinga State Hospital's prisoners unit. There was only one out of 28 units at the hospital. State prison inmates are housed in Unit 21. I like to think they named the unit after my first book, Proposition 21, but of course, that is just me. I arrived to Colinga State Hospital in October 2013. I arrived in a prison van. My first thoughts were a bit of terror. The perimeter gates of the hospital are intimidating. I judged the inside would look like the exterior. State prison guards worked the gates and dashed my hopes of getting away from them. I had flashes of the Riverside County Jail, but in place of tough gangs, my peers would be insane psychopaths. Fudge. Nope, not at all. There was friendly psych techs, hospital police officers, and unassuming sex offenders. Colinga State Hospital is best known for housing California sex offender population, who have served their prison terms yet are deemed not safe enough to be out in the community. Colinga State Hospital also houses mentally ill offenders who have completed their prison term, yet are deemed not mentally stable enough to be released. Unit 21 has 50 beds for the state prison inmates committed to the hospital. I fell into this group of what are called patients. Patient. I could get used to that. My first experience as a patient came with a detailed physical by a friendly nurse. In prison, a nurse is hesitant to touch an inmate with a peering prison guard watching over them, so I enjoyed the privacy of an honest physical. Stepping for the first time into a Colinga State Hospital hallway is forever etched into my mind. The bright colors and spaciousness of what to me resembled an airport concourse flooded my brain with joy. I had the awe of a child going to Disney World. I spotted a gym, post office, restaurant, barbershop, and a library. Finally, after 10 years of prison, I had gotten myself into something awesome. The psych tech escorting me to Unit 21 was an African man named Gad. I didn't know it then, but I would later come to find out that Gad had a lot of gifts. One being his superhero-like abilities to stop people from hurting themselves or others. Did you know Gad once thwarted a bank robbery? Gad took the would-be robber down, making my African brother Gad more of an African hero than most of us. After Gad, I met Jason. With Jason, I met the unit supervisor, Jose. Jason and Jose became my favorite people to play sports with. Not only were they both good at sports, but they had the best attitudes. I couldn't help but have fun when they were around. Two good role models for everyone. When it came to playing card games, there was only one psych tech to go to. Hands down, Katrina did the best when it came to getting the lowest functioning patients out of bed to participate in an engaging activity. She seemed to be the best and only person with the gift of not only treating everybody the same, but getting every patient engaged in activities the same. That is a talent one could only be born with. As for my peers, I tried to look out for the guys not doing as well as me. Just because I was high functioning did not make me any better than anybody. In my time, I ran across a few other patients who seemed to function well. One thing all of us patients had in common, regardless of our ability to function, was knowing where we currently were was a million times better than state prison. Every patient had his own prison horror story to tell. One thing about being in the state hospital as a prison inmate is that you are only there to be made sane enough to be returned to prison. Being made better involves attending therapeutic groups led by an all-star cast of professionals. I didn't know how important these professionals would become in my life as I made the transition back to prison. I didn't know how motivated I would be today. I don't know how motivated I would be today without the gift of my Colinga State Hospital journey. Have you heard of DBT? Dialectical Behavior Therapy. Dialectical Behavioral Therapy. I had it, but the backbone of using DBT skills involves making wise mind decisions.
This call and your telephone number will be monitored and recorded.
You do that by balancing out your emotional and rational thoughts. It was a blessing that group was led by a sagacious psychologist. Dr. Machado became my favorite doctor and group leader. She has creative ways of getting us engaged and also seemed to always have another awesome staff member helping her run groups. Memories of her group still linger in my synapses. I can't help but see light when it gets dark here. Wouldn't you know it, After 1 year of joy and peace, I was returned to state prison. A state hospital is like sitting on a lazy boy. Prison is like sitting on a park bench. From my park bench, thank you to all I enjoyed at Colinga State Hospital. I enjoy today's success with your hands on my back. A Halloween story. What's up, everybody? This is Shawn Khalifa writing to you from a state prison in Chino, California. I just transferred here from a prison in San Luis Obispo. It is nice being back in the ghetto empire I grew up in. I was incarcerated at the age of 15 and given a life sentence in the adult prison system. I am 27 years old now, so it has been almost 13 years for me. I know a thing or two about prison, particularly the scarier things. It is only fitting that Halloween is approaching because I have a scary story to tell. When transferring to a new prison, you have thousands of eyes watching you, people wanting to know who you are. Where are you from? Who do you know? What are you about? Do you suck bleep? The last question being unique to the prison I just arrived to. That question is scary enough to be a Halloween story of its own. My answers are, I am Shawn Khalifa. I came from San Luis Obispo. I don't know anybody. I am not really about anything. And no, I don't do that. Once past the questions, it's go time. You are thrown into a completely unknown new world. This one being 150 people being packed into an overcrowded dorm. My nightmare starts with 12 years of cell living. Now it's all of a sudden, welcome to the dorms. I've always been spooked by the dark. You know the eviler things live in the dark. So it is my hope to avoid that. I can't believe it. My property and hygiene is in a dark place. I don't want to enter for fear of being taken. I turn to my bunkie for courage. Do you think they're going to hurt me? I ask him. No, Sean, don't worry. They won't hurt anybody. I want to believe him, but I don't. I just spent the past 12 years in controlled environments. There were always gun towers around to protect you if something went down. Not here, though. This is the dorms, and there are no COs around in the dark places. I think back to my Paris, California neighborhood, where a group of young thugs put a gun in my face and asked me where I was from. I didn't respond San Luis Obispo. I told them I was from nowhere. Seeing a bullet down the barrel of a gun is the courage I summoned to enter the darkness here at the state prison in Chino. I open the locker at the foot of my bed. Light is let in, and they begin to scatter. The scariest thing to happen to me since Pelican Bay State Prison is having a locker full of cockroaches. It has been 12 years since I have encountered such creatures. They scare me. I wish everybody a happy Halloween, and thank you for reading my Halloween story. Before I go, I must thank three psychologists who dared to be a friend to me. Dr. Tasha Arneson, I met you in January of 2004, and you taught me not to limit my potential by being my own worst enemy. Dr. Marissa Machado, I met you in October of 2013. You taught me how to balance my thoughts so that my actions would reflect wisdom. Dr. Eileen Warren, I met you in March of 2015, and you taught me not to let my environment make or break me. I am Shawn Khalifa, wherever I am.